Yeah. What does that mean? I am
Animal.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Come on, man.
You're gonna
take a bite.
You're gonna,
no, man.
You're gonna,
one donut should
be
gonna
two bites. You're that little dainty.
Not,
I, yeah. I,
oh man. Come on, man.
Yeah, one donut. Come on. Hey,
those are supposed to be eaten in one
you
bite.
Can't take one.
That's why they're that size,
can't take
man.
Two no, bites
man.
Out of take, one donut. Take two bites. Oh, take one bite.
You'd be there all day.
That's
you'd be there all day eating them donuts.
It's only six donuts in a pack.
It's very dainty of you, Chuck.
Take it. All right, man. One donut.
All right, sir. What is this show about? Oh, that's right, basketball. Let's take a look at some highlights as we welcome you to Inside the NBA, presented by Kia.
And, not ghetto for taking one bite of
Paul George.
Of it. That's not ghetto.
No, you ghetto if you get them powder donuts and walk around with them big ass white lips off.
Well, I guess I'm ghetto.
I want to talk with somebody.
Say, Ernie?
Okay, nobody wants to talk with. Nobody talking with powder donut all over your big lips.
Anyway, Paul George knocks down the three.
Yeah, thank you, Kenny, for picking that up.
You know, it's going to be interesting where the Clippers finish and how long Kawhi is going to be out, because. That's going to be the key.
Yeah, Norman Powell connected for three there, and then Paul George for a triple.
And Paul has that triple green light. He always plays like this. Very aggressive. Nice shot right there.
Norman Powell with a four-point play.
Ah. Yeah, I mean, this guy, Reggie Jackson, has revamped his career for sure.
Had 23 tonight, did Reggie Jackson. Lillard connects. In fact, Lillard in the fourth quarter tried to bring Portland back into this thing.
That was a hell of a jump stop, Ernie.
Oh! Ooh. That kid got so much talent. I wish he would go to the basket a lot more instead of just selling for jumpers.
Yeah, Anthony Simons right there.
Damn.
But he just
seen that before in the dunk contest.
Yeah, but we need to see it in the game.
We need to see it in the game.
He Nicholas Batum had 22 most points in the game since the 17-18 season.
That's ridiculous right there.
What, that stat?
That stat's ridiculous.
Got him.
It's true.
Since 17-18?
17-18 season. Nurkic connected for three. Batum again for
this
three.
His former team letting them know you shouldn't let me go.
He went 6 out of 8 from the promised land.
Little ball down there.
And Paul George 24-9-7. The Clippers have won 5 in a row. Portland still has not won a game on the road. They're 0-5. They join the Detroit Pistons and the Houston Rockets as the only teams winless at home.
That ain't a good thing to be in.
And this is already the third meeting between the Clippers and the Blazers, and they're, 10 or 11 games into the season. And they play once in December, and that'll wrap up the season series between these two. What do we know about the Clippers? I know you talked about Kawhi Leonard. What do we know about the Clippers right now on this early season run of 5 straight wins?
You know, Paul George said it best. He said, look, we got a couple guys down, but we're still talented enough to play very well. When Paul George is aggressive like this and his game is on, he's hard to stop. The problem we've seen with Paul George is, especially in postseason, I know it's too early to be talking about postseason, but he kind of fades away. But look, he's playing like this. He's the main guy out there. He doesn't have to share the ball with Kawhi Leonard. When he's playing aggressive like this, he's a killer. Now, when Kawhi comes back, can he still have the same mentality?
Portland Trailblazers, meantime, second best road record in the league last year, 0-5 this year. Give me take the temperature of the Blazers 10 games, 11 games into the season, Kenny.
Don't count points. Don't count assists. Don't count rebounds. Count chest bumps, high fives, and enthusiasm. That's basically it. There's a lack of enthusiasm. Those are the things, dance moves on the side, you know, those are the things you can count. If you watch those in a game and you watch the Clippers and you watch them, they're going to be more chest bumps, more high fives. You know, I always, you know, been around people that said enthusiasm and passion is the only route to greatness. And you don't see that. And it's something that you can't measure, because you can't say, oh, guys, not enthusiastic. But I can count chest bumps. I can count high fives. And I don't see it on a regular basis. And that's when you say a team has swag. They walk around differently. They pat each other on the butt. They just walk differently when they do that. And that is the missing element that you have seen in the past from the Portland Trailblazers that is not there, in my estimation.
Yeah, and for me, I've said it. They need to make a trade. Simple. They got a decent team. They're not a contender. I like their players, but they just don't fit together. They need to make a trade to try something different. And even if it doesn't work, you're still stuck in the same boat. But you can't do the same thing. The move is going to end badly again. I think Boston, Philly, Portland, all three of those teams need to make a trade because the way they are constructed, it's not good enough, plain and simple. And I just feel bad for Dame because he wants to stay in Portland, but this going to end the same way it's ended the last few years. So I just feel bad for him.
117-109, Clippers over the Blazers tonight.